Hi friends, welcome to ODI Tutorials. Today I am going to explain interface, that is mapping in 12C with example from source flat file to target table. So I have some CSV file here. I am opening that CSV file. I have created one directory in my C, that is a source files. I have a CSV file here, comma separated value here. I am opening it here, you can see. First record is my header, that is your columns. Then second record onwards my records, that is my data. So each column is separated by comma. So that is CSV file, comma separated value file. This is my source, and using this file I'm loading into my target table, that is a database. I'm opening in SQL developer. Have a target schema called a TDEV. So here I have a table structure, same thing as a source file. Here I don't have any data now. So using this ODI 12C, we are going to load this data from flat file to target database table. So for this, first we need to create a technology. Inside technology, we need to create one data server and physical schema and logical schema for file technology. So in default, in ODI you will get a default here, you can see a data server, that is file generator. So here we are using the file, and the JDBC URL you can see DB file. In 12C you will be getting additional parameters here. In 11C these parameters is not available, we are passing manually with separated by question mark. But in 12C all file parameters, that is the properties, directly we are providing here. This is the value here. Value, some of the values is default provided, that is a false, and you can see default value it is selected. And then there is a description also about those parameter values, you can see. Then you can see additional option key in 12C, that is HDFS file. So it is not available in 11G. In 12C you are getting this HDFS, that is Hadoop file. Okay. Hadoop distributed file system. You are getting additional option in ODI 12C. So currently I am not using Hadoop here. I am going to use some flat file. So I am using directly same data server, and I am creating physical schema here. So in ODI, physical schema is nothing but your for files we are calling as a folder. One directory is nothing but your physical schema. So my file is available in source files here. So I am copying this path for files. So, both for work schema and main schema, I am using the same directory for files. Save this physical schema. It is giving information saying that you need to assign this physical schema to your context. Okay, then only you can use in a designer. It's information only. I have created my physical schema. Then go to logical technologies and go to file and right click. You can create a logical schema here. So I'm following naming standards LS, then file source. You can assign for global, if you want to assign for dev production also you can assign that. Okay, then I'm closing this. My topology objects has been done. Now I'm going to designer. So next thing is you need to create a directory in models. So that is, you can create one folder for the specific to your sources, then it is very easily identified in sources systems. Then I'm creating a folder, model folder here, folder files source. Then that done, top of that I'm creating the model. So my model is SRC. You can use any naming standards. Currently I am using some standards I am using here. Okay, then select your logical schema here. Okay, here we are providing model name, selecting file technology and logical schema which was created recently for files. Then save this model. For files, remember this, we are not doing directly reverse engineering here. For files, for flat files we are not doing reverse engineering here. So how to get those files? So go to your model, right click over model, there is option called new data store. You can see here there is option called new data store. Click on this, then provide your file name, or you can say table name or object name. So here I'm providing emp file. So if you go to browse here, you can see list of available files in your directory. That is your physical schema. Wherever you are giving this physical schema location, it will give all the available files. You can choose that file name, okay? Then go to your files tab. Here is the main option for your files. So here, if you go to your files tab, you can see file format. My file is CSV file. It is delimited file. It is not a fixed one. Then header. So I have one header, right? That is one record header. It is nothing but your column names and one header. Then records operator is nothing is there. It's a default MS-DOS. Then field separator. Each field is separated by comma. You can see here others. It is not a tab separator. It is not a space. It is a comma. CSV file. Then default it will be converted into hexadecimal. Then here, if you have a text delimiter, if you have a text encoded with a double quotes, you can specify here double quotes or single quotes. You can specify here. Otherwise, you can ignore this. My text is directly is available. My text is not enclosed any with a single quotes or double quotes. You can ignore this. So this is the default options you need to provide for files. File format, if you have a header, specify that. Then field separator, that is data is separate, each column is separated by comma. My file, that is CSV file. Then go to your attributes. Now you can click on the matching data. Attributes is nothing but your columns from your flat file, all your field names. Then save your file first, then click on reverse engineering button. So agent you can select that. Then so here you can see all the columns, and the default data type will be string when you are importing from file, and the length, the physical length will be 50. Then you can modify based on your data type. Otherwise you can use any conversion functions while doing mapping. That is called expression. So you can use expression and you can convert it from string to data, string to number. So if you are processing your data, that is a part of your transformation. So my source file is ready. I have a target table already in my model, target model. There is a table here. Then go to your projects, your mappings. This is the earlier mapping I have created. Then right click, then new mapping here. Then create your own user defined name. That is follow the standards, naming standards. Depending on your project, if you have a standard document maintaining in your project, you can follow the same as naming standards document. Okay. Then I'm creating here. So here you can see you can drag and drop your source data store. Data stores is nothing but the tables or flat files. Okay. This is my flat file, source file. I'm dragging and dropping here. Then if you want to use any conversions, you can use the expression here. There is a transformation available. That is a component in ODI, YC, same as Informatica or any other ETL tools. Those are transformations are providing by ODI. Then you can drag your target table. So I'm not using any transformation now for this example. Later we'll go for other examples to show how to use it. Other transformation, filter, this thing, expression, so other lookup pivot. Okay. Then I'm doing the mapping here, direct mapping, because all column names I'm using by name auto mapping. Then all mapping has been done. You can see here. Then go to your physical tab. Select your LKM and IPM. So what is the LKM you are using? Your source is file. Your target is a database. So your staging also database. So LKM will be your source to staging. My source is file. So I need to use SQL LKM file to SQL, or you can use file to Oracle. If you want to use a SQL loader, if it is external table, you can use external table. Okay. But here my staging is SQL, that is Oracle. I'm going to use LKM file to SQL. So from first we are loading data from flat file to your staging the database, then database to again target table we are loading. Again it is a database. So LKM file to SQL, then go to your target table, click on this diagram, then select IKM here. You can use incremental update or control append IKM, that is Oracle or SQL you can use. I'm using SQL control append. Currently I'm not going to use flow control here. So if you enable flow control, you have to use CKM. So currently I don't have a constraints. I'm not defining any constraint here. I'm not doing any data quality here. Simply you can make it false. So if you are using flow control, static control, you should use CKM. That is another knowledge model data quality. So that will go through in next other sessions related to data quality in ODI. Let's save this mapping. So what I have done, first I have created a data server for file, physical schema, logical schema, then designer I have created model for file, then I have created a mapping, and my source is file and my target is a table. So LKM I am using LKM file to SQL, then IKM I am using IKM or control append. Then you can run your mapping now. Now you can click on run button. You can see here my physical mapping design. Click on OK. Session has been started. So you'll be getting some warnings here, right? Because file data type is a string. You can refresh in the operator. You can see the today's session. So this is the cleaning means deleting all your work tables. And the main means your main data loading mapping here. You can see here. This is my LKM loading data into your CDALA table from your flat file. You can see. To close this, you can see here. Selecting data from flat file. This is my flat file. I'm loading data into your CDALA table. This is the LKM job. Then IKM job is, if you go here, you can see. This is target, right? Control append. So directly selecting data from CDALA table and inserting into target table. If I go to definition, you can see total number of inserts, total number of rows. If I go to my database, you can verify here. See, 14 records has been loaded here. You can see. So we are using control append. If you run it again, it will append the data. Append the data means it won't consider the existing data. Simply it will insert again same data from source. So 14 records already available. Again it will insert 14 total. It will be 28 records. I'm running again. You can see here because I don't have any constraint. I'm not creating any constraint in target table. That's why it is allowing here. So as of now we are not using any data quality. That is restricting duplicate records. Again you can see 14 records has been inserted here. Now you can go to database, and this is a SQL developer. I have connected to pdev is my schema, target schema. I'm re-triggering my table data. Now you can see total 28 records are available because we have loaded twice. 14 records we have loaded twice, and we're not used any data quality means we're not restricted any duplicates data. That's why it is accepting all data. And the knowledge model we have used the control append. Control appending means appending the data on the table. It won't verify existing data. Simply whatever data is available from source, it will add into the table. That is control append. So this is the way we can go for loading data from flat file to table. So thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to get more videos from ODI.